Which video generation model is best? Is the WAN 2.1 model for videos better than Hunyuan Video and Zora? In a few minutes you can compare and judge it yourself, and you will even know how to install it. This video covers both text to video as well as image to video. You will learn how to set up WAN 2.1 and Hunyuan Video in ComfyUI, which you can use both with your local GPU as well as with a cloud GPU. If you are new to ComfyUI, then you can watch this video. If your GPU is not powerful enough, in this video I show you how to use ComfyUI with a cloud GPU, including several free hours each month. And in this video I answer if renting a cloud GPU is worth it. Again, you can download the custom ComfyUI workflows I've used in this video from my Patreon for free. There is no paywall. And as usual, you can find all links in the description. And remember that you can pause the video anytime in case you need to take a closer look. Let's begin. Most probably you need to update your ComfyUI installation. This is the version of ComfyUI and the ComfyUI manager I have used in this video. Moreover, the PyTorch version for the video models has to be at least 2.4. Well, if you update your complete ComfyUI installation, this should be done automatically. Let's start with Hunyuan Video, both text to video as well as image to video. If you have watched my video about using a cloud GPU, then you already know the text to video version. These are the files you have to download, but it's not complicated. You don't need them all, and you can copy the links from my Patreon without any paywall. The green files are required, but cover already text to video and image to video. Instead of using the very large original Hunyuan files in this video, we will use the smaller quantized models. The Q8O models in the list have nearly the same quality but are smaller, and you can choose even quantized models smaller than these Q8O models in case VRAM is an issue. In this case, you could think about using the optional blue Lava Llama FP8 scaled text encoder model file in order to save more VRAM. Nevertheless, the optional files in blue at the bottom are the original model files and are covered by the workflows too. So feel free to download them too if you have the required VRAM. As usual, you have to put the downloaded files into the appropriate ComfyUI model folders. As I said, the green files are a must and the blue files are optional. Let's have a look at the workflows. This one is for Hunyuan text to video. Before starting the workflow, check if all models are assigned to the related nodes accordingly. This is the GGUF unit loader. In case you want to use the standard diffusion model loader, you have to activate it by pressing Ctrl B and connect it to the appropriate nodes. Here you can select the Lava Llama 3 FP8 model in case VRAM is an issue. In order to test the workflow, I use the standard 20 steps. Hunyuan Video uses 24 FPS, so a length of 49 frames is 2 seconds plus 1 frame. However, the workflow did not work with 480p on my AMD RX 6800 with 16 GB VRAM, so I have divided the width and the height by 2. The result is quite small, but at this stage we are only testing the workflow anyway. As I wanted to compare the quality and generation speed of the video models, I had to increase the quality settings and the length of the videos. Due to the limitations of my GPU, I had to use a cloud GPU, in this case Lightning AI. Check out my detailed how-to video on setting up ComfyUI with Hunyuan Video. You can easily use the workflows and models shown here in this cloud GPU too. Let's have a look at the 480p and 720p settings. I've increased the number of steps from 20 to 30 in order to get better quality. The length is 121 frames, which equals 5 seconds plus 1 frame. Width and height are set to 480p. For 700p, the settings remain same. I only had to increase the resolution. We will take a look at the generation time and quality after this chapter. The basic workflow of Hunyuan image to video is similar to the text to video workflow, but some notes have been added to include an image. The workflow additionally uses the Lava Llama 3 clip vision model, and you can download the example image from my Patreon. Again, I've selected 20 steps, a shorter length and a lower resolution in order to test the workflow on my local GPU. For the 480p and 700p versions, I have updated the parameters in the same way as before, increasing the steps, the length and the resolution. Let's continue with WAN 2.1, another great model for video generation. These are the files you have to download for WAN 2.1. Similar to HunyuanVideo, the green files are required but cover already text-to-video and image-to-video. Again, instead of using the very large original files, I've used the smaller Q8O quantized models with nearly the same quality. You can choose even smaller quantized models in case VRAM is an issue. The orange Q8O file is only needed for 700p image to video and demands highest GPU performance. The optional files in blue at the bottom are the very large original model files and are covered by the workflows too. Again, you have to put the downloaded files into the appropriate ComfyUI model folders, and only the green files are a must. The workflow is less complex than the Hunyuan one, but believe me, it's quite powerful. I'm sure you've already noticed the negative prompt. So far, I haven't touched it, but feel free to do your own tests. Again, you can choose the load diffusion model node with one of the large original models, or just a smaller quantized model. Just assign the node accordingly. Steps are set to 20 again, and this time the length is 33 frames. WAN 2.1 uses 16 FPS, so the length is 2 seconds plus 1 frame. Again, I've used a much smaller resolution than 480p for testing purposes. For the high quality workflows, I've increased the steps from 20 to 30, increased the length to 81 frames, which equals 5 seconds, and increased the resolution appropriately to 480p and 720p. For the image to video version of WAN 2.1, similar to Hunyuan, only a few notes have been added. It uses the Clip Vision H model, and of course you have to assign an image. Steps, length and resolution remain same. You can download all workflows from my Patreon for free, including the higher quality workflows. Again, I have just increased the steps and the length, set to 5 seconds and set the resolution to 480p and 720p. By the way, the generation of these very small videos took around 400 seconds with my local GPU for WAN 2.1. For Hunyuan, I had to use the runtime parameter --CPU-VAE as all tests with the GPU way on my local GPU resulted in a corrupt result. I'm not sure if this is related to AMD ROCm or SLUDA. The generation time for Hunyuan with CPU VAE was about 700 seconds. But what about the results with high quality settings on a cloud GPU? Let's have a look at the file sizes of the generated videos. By the way, if you want to see more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell. The FPS are the green bars. I've included 700p videos from Zora, they have 30 FPS. 700p videos are larger than 480p videos, but shouldn't videos with a higher FPS have larger file sizes? Hunyuan text-to-video with 24 FPS is smaller than the 16 FPS WAN 2.1 videos. Hunyuan image-to-video is larger and Zora file size is similar to WAN 2.1. If we have a look at the average size per frame, then Hunyuan image-to-video and the WAN models generate videos with the largest file sizes. Is this already a hint to the video quality? You will see in a minute. Iteration speed and queue times are related. Let's concentrate on the queue times. Don't get confused with the 480p and 720p having similar lengths. I've used a Cloud L4 GPU for the 480p videos, and as the generation time was between 25 and 37 minutes, I've decided to choose the faster and more expensive L40S GPU for the 720p videos. Zora is purely server-based and black box, so it's not in the diagram. Queue times for WAN 2.1 are obviously longer than for Hunyuan video, although WAN uses less FPS. If you calculate this comparison using 16 FPS for Hunyuan as well, then WAN 2.1 requires around double the generation time of Hunyuan. As an intermediate result, reduce the number of steps to 20 and start with 2 or 3 seconds. This should reduce the generation time even for WAN 2.1 to 10 to 15 minutes. Here are the resulting videos in 480p, first for text to video. I wanted to have one portrait and one video with fast movement. I liked the movement of WAN very much, whereas the image style of Hunyuan is a bit more my taste. The source image clearly influences the image to video results. Movement of WAN is better again. For the 720p videos, this time including Zora, I was really surprised. In fact, I had expected more from Zora. Again, I liked the image style from Hunyuan very much. Nevertheless, WAN's movement is superior. Unless I could only generate one video of the running dragon with WAN, and I have no idea why there is this large tooth or horn, but the movement is simply great. By the way, I have generated the image templates with Flux, and WAN 2.1 image to video is my favorite of this comparison. What about you? Which results do you like most? Please write in the comments. WAN 2.1 is better than I've expected. The movement is great, and especially when using image to video, the results are brilliant. Nevertheless, the generation time is challenging. I will try using the 700p model with 20 steps and only 3 or 4 seconds with a powerful cloud GPU. This should be a good compromise. Will you try WAN 2.1 video or Hunyuan video in the cloud or with a local GPU? Please write in the comments. And if you don't have a keyboard nearby, just leave a like.